just calling into your new robot girlfriend, we are going to get Windows for free. How to get Windows 10, 11, well, 7, 8, 10, 11, 9. What happened to Windows 9? I think, you know, they banged their heads too much into the walls and they forgot that when you count to 10, you also need 9. But yeah, let's not talk about that little thing. You want Windows 10 and you've heard this notion that, oh, Windows cost $100 and stuff like that. Not really. If you are Dell, HP and stuff like that, you get a Windows license for, I think we made a calculation on my stream, that about either a dollar or under a dollar per license that Dell, HP and those kind of companies are paying for it. So that means that you are not paying $100 for a license for Windows when you're buying a Dell, HP, Lenovo computer. But I'm now going to show you guys and girls and Asian robots how I have gotten Windows for free for, well, close to a decade now, if not more. One of them is for Windows' own site. Product activation for Windows Online and support telephone numbers. So, depending on what version of Windows you're using, you basically just follow this little thing here. During the activation process, and then it depends on which one you're using, like activate the process, and you just say, I have not access to the internet. Or if you're really paranoid, just disconnect your internet and stuff like that, and you get a phone number where you can call in and activate it. And you just call this little amazingly AI alien robot that may be your new girlfriend, because she's talking to you and she has a female voice. We know how nerds are when a female is talking to you, even if they are like made out of ones and zeros or human plot. They get all fuzzy down below. So calm your horses a little bit, don't get too excited and get through the process, and she will ask you and stuff like that about some stuff. And I think either she just goes right into it, or she's asking you if it's an upgrade and stuff like that, and you just say, yeah, it's an upgrade. You just try different, like, if you do it wrong the first time, you just call her up again like a really good stalker, like, hey, it's me again. And then you find the right one where she's like, I think when I did it under Windows 10 and 8, it showed some numbers on my screen. And again, it's fucking years since I've done this, because I do the other method, the two other methods that I will talk about later. But it showed some numbers on the screen that you then pressed in, like a, you know, like a good little boy. You press those in and she will then tell you some numbers, and you have to have pen and paper ready and type it down. It's basically activation numbers, and you can get her to repeat it, and you can actually use those activation numbers again and again and again and again. Here's the thing, Microsoft don't care. Microsoft have long said before they rather have you using a cracked version than the competitor's operating system. They don't really care that much. But by doing this instead of hacking Windows and getting cracked versions, you still get access to everything that Windows will provide you, the updates and stuff like that. What I do also is that you just go on here and you... This is just a site that compare prices for Windows Pro license keys. And you can see here if there's OEM or retail keys. And OEM means that, you know, it's still, you know, the same keys that Dell gets and stuff like that. And is this legal? It's a gray line, because you can only use an OEM key if you are an OEM, aka, you know, with Dell, you know, all of these things. But again, Microsoft don't really give a fuck. So you just buy what, and use a site that you trust. There are some sites that are really fucking dubious, and I don't know if any of these sites here are good sites. I use some Penguin or Pingross or what the fuck, Kingping or something like that. I can't remember what it was called. I used back in the day. But you can see the prices for the sites that you have over here. But again, do your research with the sites that you're getting key from, because it is a predatory market. So some sites, they will go in and, or people will make fake sites up, and they will scam you. I have been caught in a scam 2 times by buying a key for a game, and I didn't get the key. I got a key for a total other game, but I always get the when I buy games, I always get the buyer protection, and that's like $1 or $2 sec. So this is one of them. The other one is that if you have an old pro version key, those seems to work the most. So if you have an old, like, fucking laptop from 10 years ago with a Windows 7 Pro license or Windows 8 Pro license and stuff like that, or if you're working somewhere and they're throwing out a computer and behind it is a license key with Windows, you know, Pro, whatever, or even just a normal Windows key, take a picture of them, and more than likely, or more than not, they are working. And you just go home and you can activate Windows with that one. I know plenty of IT people that have done that again for years. You know, they just take a picture of the key behind a computer at work or that are going to be decommissioned, thrown out. Preferably do it for a computer that's going to be thrown out, just in case. Take a picture of that key, and my experience is the pro versions, like if it's Windows Pro, whatever version of Windows Pro, they seem to be working the best. The last video I saw from Paul's Hardware, again, I'm outing him out here a little bit, and it's from this year, I think it was from this year or late last year, he was still using a Windows 8 Pro key to activate Windows 11. So you don't have to pay for Windows. And if you don't want to do any of these things, if you think like getting a key from a site or reusing an old key or just calling into your new robot girlfriend to get her to activate it, you could just use Windows without activating it, Windows 10 and 11. You just lose your customization. That's like, you don't really lose anything other than, you know, changing the wallpaper, changing some customization aspect of Windows. And if you really want a nice wallpaper, just download Bing Wallpaper. And every day you get a new wallpaper. And you can select between three or different wallpapers each day. If you don't like it, just click select new wallpaper. And things like three different wallpaper of the days that you have to choose from. It's that fucking simple. See you all later. Bye bye.